Hello guys, welcome to TechLinus. Myself Divyansh Garge. Today we will be discussing about functions. First of all, we need to know that what are functions and why do we need them. Actually, functions are the small things make our program short. And first, we have to write the complete program again and again and give the input again and again in different cells of this Jupyter notebook. But now it will be not there. We will first defining a function simply, and then we will be calling that function. I will be doing it practically so that you may understand it. So first let's start with it. We will be starting with the smaller ones, then again and increasing them. Let's define a function. That def is the code for defining a function, right? Def stands for defining. Now you have to take any of the variable you want. It could be a big name or something, anything else. Like we take here name, that is brackets. If you want any default name should be there. When we were calling the function, there we don't know any of the name, so that the default name can be printed. You may choose it. I will be telling you later on. First let's do it. Name, right? Sorry, then colon at the end of this line is necessary, right? Now we'll be defining the function, that what is the function is about. Let's print hello. Sorry, just a minute. It's a string, right? Hello, hello world, right? This we will be printing it. Now the function has been defined here. Now we'll be calling of the function, right? How to call the function? Directly write the function we have chosen. Here we have chosen the function name, right? Let's write the name here. Now run it. See, it is printing us the word hello world. It was such a simple one that we think that is difficult. Further we will be doing it, it would be easy and helping us to take the longer codes just in a short one, right? Let's do it the next one here by inserting the next cell. See, define name. We take a default name as well, that is n equal to string Raju. Let's say it. Right, then define here print. We will be printing here n name, that is n plus string. Here, do you want space here? Then write anything, Raju, hello, right? Let's do it like this. Right, now we will be calling off the function. Sorry. Name. See, if we don't write any of the name in the default, it will print Raju only. See, so it is printing Raju hello. If we write any of the other name in this, it will print that name. Right, I write now name. I write my name, that is Divyansh. Just a minute. See, I write name Divyansh here. Now it will be printing Divyansh hello. See. So it is printing Raju hello, that is of upper one name. Now Divyansh hello. It will update yourself without any again and again writing the same function. In just one step it will print like this. In this we can further give the double input as well for giving two inputs simultaneously. Let's write it. Insert like defining, we write the same function name, take n as this, or n comma l, two variables we have to take because there are two inputs we will be giving him simultaneously, right? So now defining that print, that is n plus space between these two letters, then shift plus L, right? These two will be given simultaneously. Let's call the function, that is name. We need to write the names what we have to print. Like I print my complete name, that is Divyansh, comma, that is Garg. So it has printed the same thing, that is Divyansh space Garg. If it doesn't write the space between them, it will combine them. See, I'll show you. Just see it. So it has combined without space. It has joined two words. That's why we write a space in between them. Right. See, we will be practicing some questions on this topic, that is functions. First of all, we will be starting with the question of Fibonacci series. Many of you may not know the what is Fibonacci series. May I tell you first, I'll explain you what is this Fibonacci series. Just a minute. Fibonacci series, right? What is the Fibonacci series? Is the sum of previous two sums. Like if we start from 1, then again sum of back two terms, that is 1, now 2, now 3, then 5, then 8, then 13, and so on. What is the relation between them? Though you can start it from 0 or 1, it's your choice, but this is the same one, right? What is the relation in that the other further term is the sum of previous two terms? Like you can see from the third one here, 2 is the sum of these two, and this is the third, 3 is the sum of previous two terms. Like this was, all of them are related. The first two terms are fixed, that are 1, right? These two terms are, if you can start from 0 as well if you want, that is 0, 1, 1, that same, right? So this was about the Fibonacci series. Now we'll be printing it on our Jupyter notebook. So what should be the this code we should write over here? You should think it. You can pause the video over here and then move to the further. I will be providing the answer next. I will be solving it. You can stop here and try it yourself first. I hope you have tried it once. Now I will be writing it. First define. We will be using the function over here. The name of the function will be taking here fib, that is fib. Then in the bracket we can use any of the variable a, b, c, and for the numbers we will be printing, right? Here we use n, right? Then if, we will be using the if else statement over here, that is if n less than equal to 1, we will be printing the number itself, 0, 1, 1. As I have talked to you previous, sometime back, that is 0, 1, 1. Then starting from there, that are back sums 2, 5, like this, 2, 3, 5, right? Now we'll be writing it. There is colon at the end. It's necessary, you know. Then return first. Return n, right? The number itself. Then else statement. Else fib. Sorry, return. Fib. N minus 1 plus n minus 2. That is fib minus 2. The sum of previous two terms, that is n minus 1 and n minus 2. You can take both of them, right? We have to add the previous two terms, like the 5 was the sum of previous two, 2 plus 3, right? Like that. Now we will be giving the input. That is, what is the n we will be giving on our output screen? That is n equal to int input, like this. Now we can also do it step by step or call the function. First we will be calling it, like that is fib, and we will be calling the function, right? We can first, we will be running it like this. See, it is asking us the input. Let's give it 5. Just a minute, sorry. We need to write the for function also. We have missed that. That is for I in range n. That is, we have to write the numbers, not the last digit we have written. That's why we have to write that. For I in range, print fib n. Sorry, I we will be writing over it. That is, stepwise we have to write the numbers, right? So let's again write the function there. So it is printing the first 5 digits of a Fibonacci series, that is 0, 1, 1, 2, 3. It is defaultly starting from 0 only. If you want to start it from 1, you can mention it over here. Initialize the statement that I equal to 1. Right? Now you can run it again. 5. Sorry, it is... As we have used a for loop here, that's why it is not taking the initial value I equal to 1, right? If you want I to be 1, you can use while loop here. Let's use it, try it with that also. That is I equal to 1. Just a minute. While I less than equal to n. Then the function itself. Then we will be incrementing the value I plus 1. See, we have, so it is starting from 1 now. As it's in for loop, it's by default starting from 0. Now it's starting from 1. You can again run it to, for higher number, let's take 10. 10 first values. So it is giving us 1, 2, 3, 5, 8 and so on. This was the Fibonacci series. There are further many more programs, small programs to be done. Let's practice some of them, like how to double the power, right? Define the function, that is double. There is a square of the function. We can write double or let's write square over here. Square, right? And first define the function, that is print, that is n star star 2. Double star stands for the power, right? I have told you. Then we will be giving the input, that is n equal to int input. Then printing that statement, that is calling that function double, that is n, right? Now running the function, asking us the input, let's take 5. It's giving us an error that double is not defined. Sorry, we have to write square over here. I was confused a little bit. Sorry for that. Square. Now run it, that is 5. See, it's giving us the output 25, that is square of 5. Let's take any bigger number, that is 123. So it is the square of 123. Okay, so that was all about this video. If you have any doubts, you can comment down in comment section. If you have not subscribed our channel yet, please subscribe it. Thank you.